Hi guys, welcome to Websense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new Shopify tutorial again. And in today's tutorial, I'll teach you guys how you can add transparent and sticky header in your Dawn 8.0. So in Dawn 8.0, they have already added the feature to enable and disable sticky header by going to your online editor by clicking on customize. But they haven't yet added the feature for transparent header. And I'm gonna show you guys how you can do that by editing the code. So if you wanna learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. I'm putting a lot of efforts to create those videos for you guys. So without further ado, let's jump into the code. So guys, that's how default header of Dawn 8.0 looks like. So when you scroll down, it's not sticky. And when you scroll up, it's sticky and the header is not transparent, as it's the default behavior. After implementing this tutorial, you'll have your header like this. So when you scroll down, it will be sticky. Even when you scroll up and when you are on the top, it will be transparent. So let's go to the backend and implement that. So navigate to /admin and log in using your credentials. After logging in, you will see a dashboard which will look like this. After that, click on online store. And from there, you will see the activated theme. As you can see, I have Dawn 8.0 activated, which I added just 6 minutes ago in order to show you guys how you can add the transparent header feature in a freshly installed Dawn theme. Okay, now click on these three small dots and click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to duplicate your theme because we'll be doing a lot of code edits. And if you mess up anything with the code, you can easily revert it back if in case you have the duplicate version. Okay, now click on edit code. And here I have this instruction with me in my text editor. I'll put all of the code instruction in YouTube video description where you will find a blog post with all of the code instructions. Okay, now first step is to go to header.liquid. Search for header. And here we have our header.liquid file. And in here, I'll look for line number 140 and this code. So we'll be replacing this code with the following code. Okay, now let's search it. I'm just gonna copy the piece of the code and try find it in my code editor. So here's the code. Now let's replace it with the following. Copy the code and paste it. Okay, first step completed. Move on to the next one with the same file, header.liquid. In this case, we'll be replacing line number 143. That's the code which we'll be replacing with the following code. Okay, let's search for this code. Here it is, and replace it with the following code. Done. After pasting the code, don't forget to hit save and move on to the next one. Now go to line number 312, replace the following code with this code. Again, search for the code and replace it with this one. Okay. Similarly, move on to the next step. Now this code is a huge line of code where we have CSS and the JavaScript code, which you need to add in line number 817. In case you have already done some customization in your theme code, the line number might be a little different for you. So in order to find the code, you need to place this code above the schema code. Now let's search this code, which should be at the bottom of your file. Now I'm going to place my code above schema. Copy all of the code. Paste it. And hit save. Moving on to the next step. Here we have this code, which we will add in within our schema code, within our schema settings. Line number is 914. Again, it could be different if you have already done some customization in your theme. So just find this code in your schema code. And here it is. In my case, I have this line number 914. So I'm going to add a line break below the comma. Copy this schema code and paste it here. After pasting the schema code, hit save. And now final step of the code is replace this line with this line in line number 241 in theme.liquid file. Now let's go to our theme.liquid file. Here it is. In here, we will find this code. And replace it with the following code. And it's safe. Now we have updated all of the code changes which we wanted to do. Now we'll be going to our customize settings in the theme where we added the code. Click on customize. Then click on header. And here you can see we have now option to enable the transparent header. Click on enable transparent header checkmark. Hit save. Now let's preview our transparent header. Hit refresh. And now you can see we have our transparent header. And when we scroll down, you can see it's sticky all the way to the bottom. And when you scroll up. Now, what if your background of your header is not suitable for this text color? Or you want to change the color of the icons here. What you can do is simply go to customize, and here you have the option to change colors. Now click on this color box, change the color to any color you like, and it's save. Once done, you can see that our color has been updated. There you go. You can see that the colors which we have added is only for transparent header. And when you scroll down, it comes to the default colors of the theme which you have already added. And also this transparent header only works with the home page. So when you go to the inner pages, you will see that your header is in default mode. I'm working on a next level code for this. So I'm working on a code where you will be able to change the logo for transparent header only, which I'm going to release soon. I'll put all of the instruction with details in the blog post, which you can find in YouTube video description. And I hope you will like this content. Until next video, have a great day.